NRL bad boy Blake Ferguson has been cleared to return to the football field. Brad McEwen joins us now with more on this story. Brad?
Thank you, Sandra. The NRL has reinstated Ferguson's contract after a four-week alcohol rehabilitation program. He's expected to line up against former teammate Josh Dugan when Canberra play the Dragons on Saturday. There's tension at Cronulla over newspaper reports that Captain Paul Gallen and others have tried to cut a deal as the ASADA investigation drags on. Liam Cox has the details.
The uncertainty of ASADA's investigation.
I haven't heard too much.
Hovers over 10 Cronulla players.
Yeah, they're human beings. They've got partners and families. But again, you know, it's important that we all keep communicating and work through this process together.
It's reported Paul Gallen considered accepting a six-month ban in exchange for $200,000, two cars and a Harley Davidson.
And I think the criticism of Paul today is certainly way over the top and unfair, but it's there, mate. There's nothing he or I can do about it.
ASADA's interview schedule will be finalised tomorrow. At the Bulldogs, Des Hasler's intent on keeping Ben Barber away from the Broncos.
Des, has Ben Barber officially requested a release?
No.
Would you consider granting him a release if he did?
It's not my call.
Would you be reluctant to let him go, given his stature in the game?
He's a class player. I think any club would be wanting to hang on to someone like Ben Barber.
The Ben Barber issue is a sensitive one. The Bulldogs don't want to lose a player they've nurtured to be one of the best in the game, while they're also mindful of his personal situation.
You know, there's a whole lot of issues, there's a whole lot of things that Ben's working on as well. You know, I'm quite sure Ben wants to stay at the club. It's just the circumstances that are involved and are personal, and I would ask you to appreciate that.
It's the first order of business for new boss Ray Lancastle. Liam Cox, 10 News.